Well, this is actually kind of fun, but sound, it travels through water in very specific ways. And I'll tell you more about that in this episode. First, let me get myself dry. Ooh, that was fun. Phew, that took forever. Oh, finally I got myself dry after that. What I would call, sprinkler incident. I don't know what to call it. I try to do my intro in the sprinkler while getting sprayed by a sprinkler. I think it went interesting. That was pretty fun. But anyway, this entire episode is about how sound travels through water. Sound travels through water very differently than it does in other objects. But why does sound travel so differently in water? Why water? And why liquids in general? If you've ever been swimming in a swimming pool or even just swimming at the beach, you've probably noticed that things sound different underwater. Why does that happen? Well, in this episode, I'm going to take you behind the physics of sound and exploring how sound travels through water and why that is very important. And by sound traveling through water, I don't mean like this.
Ah, stop! Oh, this water's cold.
Okay, yeah, that water was pretty cold. And this.
Whoa.
Yeah, that was pretty fun, running through the sprinklers. Well, anyway, let's get right into the physics and the science of sound and how it travels through water. Let's go! Alright, first, we have to look at how sound travels. Sound travels in sound waves, which are vibrations in the air. You see, when something to make a sound, it has to vibrate or move back and forth very rapidly. How fast or slow it vibrates, and when it vibrates, makes changes in how the sound is heard. So let's just take a guitar, for example. When you strum a string, that means that it starts to vibrate. And when you do that over and over again, that causes sounds to happen. So sound is just a vibration of molecules that is moving through matter. So if we zoom into the air particles, in this case, when we're talking about the guitar, as the guitar vibrates, it starts moving the air particles around it, and it starts vibrating them, and that is what a sound wave is. It transfers all that energy through this empty space, and it's not truly empty, it has a medium. A medium is what sound travels through, and when we're talking about the guitar, in this case, the medium is air, because air is all around us, and that's how you're able to hear me from your speakers right now. So what does that have to do with sound traveling in water, and why does it sound weird underwater? Well, first, these vibrations move through air in this time because the medium is air. But what happens when the medium is water? Well, let's rewind a bit. We said that sound waves are vibrations of molecules and a transformation of energy. Well, the molecules don't actually move, and the matter doesn't actually move. It just transfers all that energy through it. Now, for sounds to be louder or sounds to be coming faster to our ears, that means that these molecules have to be packed closer to each other. That's called density. Density is how close molecules and atoms are packed together. And when it comes to density, that's very important for how sound travels. You see, air has the least density. Air is a gas, so it has the least density. That means all the particles are very, very far apart. Now, what about solids? Solids, particles are packed very, very close together, which is why sound travels the fastest through solids. Now, what about liquids? Well, liquids are somewhat in the middle. The molecules are packed pretty close together, but they're not packed as much as solids are, which is what enables liquids to move like water. And yeah, like that, as I get sprayed by water. But anyway, you see, all this happens because of these vibrations. But how does it travel differently in water? Well, since water, the molecules are packed closer together, that means that sound has an easier time traveling through water. And that's why when you hear sounds underwater, they sound more amplified, more clear, louder. And that is all because these molecules are packed so close to each other. And that means that the sound that traveling through it, if you imagine the vibrations again, when the wave goes through it, that means that there are more molecules that are transferring that energy. That means less energy is lost, meaning that the sound appears to be louder, crisper, and just sounds a lot better in general when you're in when you're underwater, or when you're swimming at the beach or in the pool, or when you're listening to things underwater. That's why it sounds so different, because all these molecules are packed closer together, meaning that's denser, meaning that the sound waves can travel through it faster and easier. And it actually travels a few times faster than air. In solids and liquids, it travels way faster than it is in air. If you think sound travels pretty fast in air, you haven't seen it in water or even solids. It is amazing. Now, why is this important? Well, marine animals that are underwater use sounds to communicate. You may not see a fish talking, but dolphins, whales, they all use water to communicate, and they use sounds to communicate through the water. And, for example, whales make these loud rumbling noises, and dolphins make these clicks. So, they're enabled to use sound to communicate through water through long distances, because, as the science we covered before, all of these molecules are compacted together, meaning that sound travels faster, further, and has higher volumes. That's why many marine mammals use sound to communicate with each other, which is very, very amazing, and it's very cool to think about it. All right, now that we've covered the science, let's get into what we learned in this episode. In this episode, I learned not to do my intro in water. But let's get into what we actually learned. In this episode, we learned that sound travels differently through water because of how the water is and how the molecules are packed closer to each other. You see, sound waves are vibrations, and these vibrations travel through molecules as sound waves. And what happens is that when these molecules are packed closer to each other, that means that the sound is able to travel faster and at a higher volume than it does in air. And solids and liquids, sound travels very, very fast because the particles are packed so close together. Many marine mammals use sounds to communicate underwater, and studying these is very, very important because it enables us to see how sound travels through different mediums, and mediums are the things that waves travel through. It is so amazing to see that science that plays a role into our everyday lives, and especially during the summer when we like to swim in swimming pools. We try to talk under there. It sounds pretty cool. All right. Thank you so much for listening to this episode of Spectacular Science. Spectacular Science produced and hosted by me, Akshay Raman. Our theme song and additional music are by Charan Ramachandran. Please visit my podcast website, spectacularsci.com, to find interactive activities, articles, and blog posts. That's spectacularsci.com. Do you have a science question you want to answer on a Spectacular Science episode and get a special shout out? We'll grab an adult and head over to spectacularsci.com/contact and use the contact form where you can send me your amazing science questions. You can also email me and find my email address there. Thank you so much. Also, don't forget to subscribe to this podcast for your listening right now. It really encourages me, and you'll be up to date on all the new episodes. Subscribe and share this podcast with your friends and family. Thank you so much. Thanks for listening, and we'll see you on the next episode of Spectacular Science next week. Keep thinking about science. Wow, running around the sprinklers was pretty fun. You know what? Let's play that clip of me getting sprayed by water in slow motion. Let's see how that looks. Yep, that looks pretty cool.